Hello guys, Tony from Expressive Imagery here. What I've got for you today is part three of the series which is documenting the building of this quadcopter aircraft. In this video we will be looking at some of the telemetry and safety features of the aircraft. So, let's get started. You'll notice that the propellers are off the aircraft, and before we power on the aircraft we must turn on the transmitter.
Welcome to OpenTX. Flight mode, normal. Flight mode, cruise, trainer,
off. So when we power on the aircraft, it will go through an initialization session.
Low battery, low battery.
What I'm going to show here is what actually happens to the aircraft if we turn off the transmitter. So the motors are now running, and if we turn it off, the motors stop and you can hear an SOS sound coming from the buzzer on the aircraft. So this will continue to play until the battery is run out. If we turn the transmitter back on,
welcome,
the buzzing will stop.
Model warning. Flight mode normal.
So it's a really good way of finding the aircraft if you need to. The next feature is an inactivity alarm, which is a completely separate buzzer. If there's no activity on the throttle, you will get the buzzing sound after 1 minute. Here we're approaching 1 minute, and here is a sound. It will continue to do that until the battery runs out or you give it some throttle. Very useful for finding the aircraft in bushes, etc. Now let's see what happens when we turn off the power to the aircraft. The transmitter should start talking to us.
RF signal low, RF signal. Critical telemetry lost.
Here we see what happens if we turn on the aircraft, we don't actually power up the motors. So that's another way of locating a lost aircraft. On the aircraft we have two displays. The first one gives you information about the flight controller. Here we see the rate profiles and the channel information from the radio, the battery voltage and the number of cells, followed by the information from the gyro and accelerometer, and then back to the rate profile again. This is what you get when you arm the motors, and then back to the beginning when you disarm the motors. The second display shows you the cell voltages and the overall voltage, and the information is sent back to the transmitter through wireless. Back on the transmitter, we can actually see the telemetry from the aircraft, which includes the battery pack voltage and the lowest cell and also the signal strength. It also has a timer which I've just engaged.
4.1 volts 83 dB 8 minutes and 12 seconds.
And so pressing that button there is very useful in flight because you get the readout of what's happening with the aircraft.
8 minutes.
Here we see how I've arranged the flight modes and speeds.
Flight mode arrow. Flight mode,
this
normal.
Is the location buzzer too, in emergency.
Flight mode, aggro. Flight mode, normal. Flight mode, fast. Flight mode, race. Flight mode, fast. Flight mode, cruise. Trainer, on.
With this switch, I use it for PID setting adjustments. So up is plus and down is minus in the settings. This is I, D, and then back to P.
Trainer off.
Very useful to do that in flight. This is what the transmitter does when the battery gets low on the aircraft.
Low battery.
And this is what happens when the signal gets low, the aircraft goes out of range.
RF signal low. RF signal critical. RF signal, critical, telemetry lost. Telemetry recovered.
That's it guys. I hope you found that of some value and of interest to you. Coming up in part 4, I'll actually be doing some flying, and it'll be the maiden flight of the aircraft, so that's going to be exciting. Thanks for watching. If you need to know more information about how this was all set up, I do have some links in the description. If you have any comments or questions, please ask away and I'll do my best to answer them. Catch you next time.